the pandemic, it's been rough. Everything that I was used to doing was stripped away. We were locked inside. I had no outlet. Only time I was away was when I was at work. And that was, it was hard. I've been working at Good Samaritan for about 6 years. I started out at the front desk. Now I'm the wellness director. We see homeless population of Atlanta, patients that are underinsured, low income. Those patients are at their most vulnerable state. And like, see Good Sam as their safe haven and how they leave with smiles on their faces, it really is rewarding. We're a very like friendly environment. Good morning, everybody, like hugs. COVID made it kind of hard because we weren't able to hug. We weren't able to eat lunch together. Listening to patients cry over the phone about their loved ones, I felt like I was surrounded by grief in every angle, anxiety in every angle. I felt alone. I felt very, very anxious, like the world was kind of like closing in. So when I first heard of the vaccine, I was already convinced I was not gonna get it. First, we didn't know anything about it. We've been researching for 2 to 3 months and now we got a vaccine that we're gonna roll out. Some people were saying, get the vaccine, this is doing your part. It felt annoying because I felt like for a minute, like that's all we seen, like was get the vaccine, get the vaccine, get the vaccine. But I like, tell me why you think I should get the vaccine. Don't just like force it on me. So I was not gonna get the vaccine, but then Brianna happened. She's somebody that values opinion because she's always been honest. Listening to her talking to me about the vaccine and what it was capable of and what it actually did, it helped me make up my mind. It's just I was already in a scared state. I was already in a vulnerable state. So I needed someone that I really like trusted to do that. It became then a no-brainer for me. I remember saying to God, like, God, I want to do my part, but I'm scared that if I get this vaccine and something happens to me, I won't be able to go home to my kids. But I'm also scared that if I don't get this vaccine and I get COVID, I probably won't ever be able to go back home to my kids. So just help me, like, lead me and guide me to make the right decision for me and my family. I went in my office at lunch and I had prayed about it, and then I got the vaccine. Interestingly, after I got my first shot, my grandma started talking to me about getting the shot, and she ended up getting it. My in-laws was like, you got the vaccine? And they kind of gave me like a strange look. They end up getting their vaccine, and whereas my husband, he was like opposed to it, but now he's made up his mind that he will get it. My dad, he came to Good Sam to get the vaccine, and I remember him telling Miss Tree, it's like, he's like, I'm not gonna let y'all stick me. My baby has to stick me. So he was actually the first person I ever gave a shot. But it felt good to see my family like kind of follow my lead. I was somebody that they trusted. Scolding people that are hesitant about the vaccine actually will push them further away. Like, they're already in a vulnerable place. There's a lot of questions that they are scared to ask because they don't want to seem stupid or they don't want to seem silly. Give them resources to explore. It's just about respecting everybody's perspective and being there for each other in any way that we can possibly be.